I started watching Game of Thrones.
Yes, Paladin Butters. Are you enjoying it?
Well, it's pretty good, I guess. But have you ever noticed that almost every time they show a guy's wiener, that guy's character is gay?
What do you mean?
Well, it's just that they have a lot of girls' boobs and vaginas and stuff, but most times they show a man's wiener, it's because that guy's in a love scene with another guy. You think it's because gay wieners are less threatening to women viewers?
I believe you might be missing the greater point of the show, Paladin Butters.
Yeah, I know. Winter is coming and there's dragons and zombies on the way. I'm pretty excited for that. Just could do with a little less gay wieners, all. I keep watching that show and I'm still waiting for the darn dragons to show up and kick everyone's butts. But all I get is wiener, wiener, wiener. It's not all gay wiener, but when they do show a straight guy's wiener, it's all soft and floppy, even though he just got done humping a pretty girl. Why is that? Because a soft wiener isn't threatening, just like a gay wiener. 2217.
Can I help you?
Hello? Is this George R.R. Martin's house?
Who is this, please?
It's two kids who want to know what happens when the dragons show up. Hello?
I'm sorry, but Mr. Martin does not see fans.
We're not fans. Yeah, we don't like it. We don't like it. And I'm pretty pissed off if you want to know the truth.
About what?
Let me talk to George R.R. Martin and I'll tell him about what.
It's the Red Wedding, isn't it? You hate how I killed everyone off.
No, sir. We just really need to know about the dragons, but they never seem to show up.
Oh, they're coming. The dragons are on their way.
When?
You really want to know?
Please. It's urgent.
All right. King Joffrey is still at King's Landing, but there's a young blacksmith who wakes up one morning with a plan, and his wiener gently hangs down between his legs. Soft and flaccid, his wiener glistens in the golden sunlight.
No. Can we skip the wiener stuff and just get to the dragons?
So, then Samwell Tarly sees the army approaching, and his wiener is about this big. He knows that Stannis Baratheon's wiener is probably shriveled from the cold. Samwell has to rally his men. So what does he do? He takes out his wiener. And he dangles it around for all his men to see.
Sir, you said peaches were coming.
Yeah, they're on their way. They're still coming. So Samwell's wiener goes...
But you said they were on their way like 3 hours ago. If I don't get pizza soon, I'm going to pass out.
Don't worry, they're coming. Pizzas are on their way. They're going to be amazing. Now, Jon Snow finally faces Jaime Lannister. And this guy's wiener is, you know, huge, right? So it's not going to be easy.
Wiener, 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 next to another wiener,
wiener, wiener,
two wieners alongside yet another wiener,
wiener party, wiener party,
party soft, wieners nice and soft, non-erect wieners.
Flopping wieners, flopping, flopping wieners, dangle wieners, dangle
wieners in my bed.
Stop, please. I can't take anymore.
But this is the best part. Right before King Joffrey gets poisoned, everyone flops their wieners all around his face.
Yeah. Listen, buddy. You promised that peaches were on the way. If they don't show up right now, you're going to have a dead kid on your hands. Do you hear me?
Okay, fine. What kind of peaches do you want?
What kind do we want? He hasn't even ordered your pizzas yet.
Don't worry, they're coming. Not just two pizzas. There's going to be five. And they're going to be huge. You won't believe it.
Come on, Scott. We're leaving.
Wait, I haven't told you what happens yet.
No.
Well, the wait is over, and Black Friday is finally here.
Niles Lawton is at the scene, and it's about time, Niles. That's right, Tom. Mall officials have said they are ready, and doors will open as soon as their guest of honor cuts the ceremonial red ribbon. This year's ribbon cutter is, of course, George R.R. Martin, who doesn't appear to have shown up yet, but says he is on his way. Just like the dragons and zombies in his novels, he is on his way.
Now, just hold on a minute. We're pretty darn sure the fastest way back to Colorado isn't on horseback.
That may be true, but horses have one quality that is unmatched by any other mode of transportation.
What's that?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to be here this morning on behalf of South Park Mall Partners and Channel 9 News, your go-to source for news, weather, and sports.
Just do it!
Very well. In the tradition of our ancestors, let's ring in the hospital. But first, I'd like to share with you a few words about my wiener. Oh, soft and pink with purple head, gently you lay with me on my bed.
Get on with it, George R.R. Martin!
Growl, growl, calls the wiener from on high. A little tiny wiener, still so pleasing to the eye.
Enough with the wieners already!
Yeah, come on!
Look at this wiener. Judge it by its size. Rub it three times and it has a surprise.
That's it. You're not delaying this anymore, you wiener-loving bitch.
Yeah, and if you believe that, I got a big floppy wiener to dangle in your face.